He's a funny man. Don't know if that's because he's Australian, but he made a lot of people laugh. And I think that the outstanding factors about him is a real team man. He cares very, very much about the group that he's involved with. You know, that's one character, a strong character that I like about Mitch. You know, it's not only did he organize the budgie smugglers and the drinks holders and all that kind of stuff, but I mean, I just think he's a wonderful bloke. I wish him all the best moving forward, you know, getting 2 years at Sussex, and you know, I wish you all the best, mate. I hope it's a great 2 years for you with a fellow Australian Jason Gillespie, and may your time in Australia with a Big Bash also be a successful one, and good luck. It was great working with you, pal, and enjoyed your pranks and your laughter and the funny side that you bring to the game of cricket. I think we all need that kind of thing. You know, you all need that sort of time where we have a good laugh and a joke, and you certainly provided that, and I wish you all the best.
First impressions was this big big oaf from Australia with ridiculously white teeth that still haven't gone anywhere. He's been a huge help. He's a great mate of mine, a great mate of everyone's in the dressing room, and will be hugely missed. There's never a dull moment when Mitch is around. And certainly through the last few years, when I've become captain, he's been a huge help for me, both in terms of advice and with him doing all of his coaching stuff at the moment as well. He actually coached me in the Sydney Sixers as well. So he's been a huge help on and off the field, and like I said, will be hugely missed. There's never a dull moment when he's around, so we'll definitely be keeping in contact with the big man.
I'm sure everyone will have a lot of funny stories for Mitch, but no, he's been a great servant to the club, as I said, and spending the winter with him last year in Sydney was awesome, something I won't forget, and having Christmas with his family. And yeah, him actually setting up a boxing fight with me and Ollie Robinson, I remember for quite a while. But no, Mitch has always got a lot of stories, and he'll be greatly missed around the Kent lads as well.
The most memory I have of Mitch is usually when I walk in the dressing room, he's gluing my shoes to the ceiling, or hiding something that I need very importantly, or winding somebody up in the way he does. When you think of Mitch, you instantly think of mischief, the prankster, his big white teeth, smiling at you, denying that he did anything wrong. But from a cricket point of view, I think that sticks in my mind is reliability, wholeheartedness, someone that is everything that is special about Kent, someone that cares not just about his own performance, but about everyone's performance and how the club is moving forward and what they're doing and getting things right.
When I got you for my first training session, very cold, rainy day, and he was standing behind the bowler's arm and umpiring and looking at him, I thought, who's this guy? Is he part of the management staff? What is he, a coach or anything? And he's like, bloody hell, mate, I'm one of the bowlers. So I'm like, okay, well, sorry about that. Anyway, and then he's been my roomie for many a games. Yeah, he definitely snores a lot. He keeps on blaming me, but yeah, he's got an interesting snore. Other than that, his Freddy Krueger mask is always a winner. He keeps on giving us big frights, and I also like that. So yeah, just everything he does, he's got this little sniff that he gives every time he wins at cards, which isn't a lot, but he'll go like, and he just makes everyone cringe and everyone hates it, but. Yeah, it's definitely a character of the game.
One of my first memories of being around the squad with Mitchy was I was lucky enough to go to Derby to run drinks for the boys, and on my first trip away on the bus, I managed to get locked in the toilets with Mitchy standing in front of the door for about 20 minutes, and yeah, I wasn't quite sure what was going on, but yeah, his antics are definitely going to be missed.
Favourite memory of playing with Mitch Clayton would be my first away trip with Kent when I was in his room, which I was very lucky. And he didn't tell me, but he brought a Freddy Krueger mask. And whenever he could, he just put it on and just jumped out at me, especially one morning when he pretended to leave the room, shut the door, then waited for about 5 minutes while I was still asleep, then woke me up to find him right in front of my face with his Freddy Krueger mask on. So that just sums Mitch up, really, all in one story, I reckon.
Well, it's hard to pinpoint one memory. I think there's so many with Mitch. Since playing with him for all these years, I think, you know, he's the life and soul of our changing room, and always cracking a joke, always making funny remarks and playing pranks. So too many to list, I think. But yeah, never a dull moment around Mitch, that's for sure.
Okay, my mate Mitch Clayton, he's been with us 6-7 years at Kent. You know, I love him that much, I've been and got my teeth done. You know, I'm gonna miss him. He's a great man, big character in the changing rooms.
But on a serious note, big man, I'm gonna miss you a lot, you know, 6-7 years. I know, you know, only down the road, and I'm sure we'll catch up when you get back. But I wanna wish you all the best, you and the family. I'm really proud of you, mate. You deserve another go, and I'm happy that Sussex have come in for you. So I wanna wish you and your family, Gemma, all the best down on the coast, and we'll catch up soon. Take care, mate.
Oh, there's lots of memories, I think, from, you know, the first time I come down here, and just being given the opportunity to be a senior bowler. You know, from when I started here, we played New Zealand to start, managed to pick up 5 wickets in that game, so it was quite a good statement for me coming down here. But all the cricket throughout, you know, making quarterfinals in the T20s, not quite getting there, getting promoted. I really feel as though this side over the next few years will win some silverware. It's obviously a shame that I'm not going to be a part of it, but I'll look back fondly at my time here and know that hopefully I have had some influence in them getting that little bit better. You know, from when I started here with Kezia as captain on to Sam to Bilbo, and we've had about 5 captains this year, so I won't name them all, but everyone, you know, Walks has been fantastic. I've loved this group. I've loved my 7 years here. It will be pretty hard leaving. I've got no doubt on Thursday it'll be a little bit emotional. I'm an emotional guy, but I've had a fantastic 7 years here. I'll walk away from here with memories for life and friends for life. And I just wish the club and the players all the best in the future, and hope that they go on and win some silverware, because this group thoroughly deserves it.